Now we have to study the microanatomy, physiology and the pathology of the liver lobule. And for this, there are the three ways of considering the liver lobule. Number one, this hexagonal look, which is classical hepatic lobule. This is dealing with the endocrinal function. When we study the endocrinal function, we consider the classical hepatic lobule because we know that blood flows from the periphery towards the center. Now come towards this portal lobule, which when we are considering the exocrinal function of the liver cells, that is its bile secretory function. Now here, what is going to happen, that the portal area is in the very center and the three triangles are touching the central vein of these liver cells, you would say. And now this portal lobule in a triangular shape area, you can very well observe, because we know that the flow of the bile is from the center towards the periphery. From this picture, we can see the direction of the flow from all the three sides. So we consider this portal lobule area. Now there is another picture you can see, in which the oval shape or diamond shape lobule is there. This is called as hepatic SNS, in which on two sides you get the portal areas and on the two corners you will find the central vein. Now for the study purpose, you can see the classical liver lobule is showing this initial zone. This zone is called as zone 1, which I have marked in pink color. Then next to it in the yellow color, you can see the zone 2, and then there is a zone 3, which is very closer to the central vein. Now zone 1, zone 2 and zone 3, these are the zonation showing the location of the hepatocytes. These the hepatocytes are called as periportal hepatocytes. Definitely they are nearest to the hepatic artery. So here they get more oxygen and nutrition, so can mostly carry out function requiring oxidative metabolism as protein synthesis. That was all about the zone 1. Now the cells of the zone 3, the blue color, you can very well see. Here what happens, hepatocytes are near to the central vein, they get least oxygen and nutrition, and these are the sites where the glycolysis, lipid formation and drug biotransformation takes place, and these are the place of those hepatocytes that undergo fatty accumulation and ischemic necrosis. The intervening zone, which is the zone 2, has got intermediate range of metabolic function. So now you can very well see that the hepatocytes, basically these cells adapt to the micro environment produced by the supply of the blood towards them or to which they are exposed. So now far you are very much clear about the three lobules, the classical hepatic lobule and this portal lobule and the hepatic SNS. Thank you.